Well, now the men's competition finding its way into the final games of these initial group stages. This is a Group F match between South Korea and Portugal, and it's top versus bottom in the table. Portugal have romped to four straight victories so far in the tournament. Korea yet to register one, but Portugal, Tom, perhaps one of the favourites for this tournament.
They really are. Portugal came in the top four last year, had an epic third and fourth playoff with Brazil that went all the way down to penalties, which they won. What I would say is, though, if you're looking at this Portuguese side, look at their defence. We saw some great defence from them before, and the Portuguese defenders both linking arms and staying within a handhold distance of each other before splitting off. Very scared of that ball splitting between the defence, the Portuguese.
The Portuguese starting lineup: Rafael Rodriguez, Raul Vieira, the goalkeeper, Samuel Melo, and Elton Pires. And they are instantly into their possession game. This is number four, Melo. South Korea have it. A chance perhaps to... They'll need an early goal if they're to get anything from this.
And just to reiterate, of course, as well, as is traditional custom in South Korea, lots of these South Korean players have got the same surnames. Lots of Chons, Parks, Lees and Kims. So we are going to go for the first names of these Korean players as well throughout this game.
Chan Won is the number 10 for South Korea. Great piece of play there by Pires. Excited to see this Portuguese lineup. And Rodriguez just flying one off the top of the stanchion.
It's a very young side, isn't it, this Portuguese team?
Yeah, they're fit. They will keep going all the way till, they'll be hoping, Saturday evening. A chance to break. Number six for Portugal. Pires just firing wide of the goal, held by Chung Hoon Lee. Teed up again for Pires. But Lee in goal for South Korea, doing well until they manage to find the ball across the goal, and it is Elton Pires. Correction, actually, Rafael Rodriguez with the goal, number eight and captain. Melo. Portugal have, in fact, changed their captain. A number of teams do this throughout the tournament. Well, Melo leading the side in this game. Plenty of goals scored by the Portuguese so far. They got five against Hungary, and Hungary are a good side. That was a 5-3 victory, a key victory as they look to progress. Oh, that's well worked, brilliantly done, and touched home by Rafael Rodriguez. Pires now, and back to the goalkeeper, and Raul Vieira has had very little to do so far. It's been quite a couple of days for Portugal, the newly crowned European champions, and the homeless World Cup team are officially affiliated with the Portuguese FA. Nicely done and well finished by Elton Pires. This Portuguese side, Tom, they're maybe not quite in a similar vein to perhaps how Ireland play, where it's all very quick and incisive. This is a more methodical build-up that you get from Portugal.
Well, that's the more traditional style. If we're perfectly honest, a team in the Homeless World Cup would aim to be very methodical around the box. If anybody was here on the live stream for the game beforehand with Romania, you saw that a lot with the Romanian front three. That they'll be a lot more cool and calm around that box. But that's a great goal by the Koreans.
Yeah, Chan Won with the goal for South Korea.
Chan Won, very much a superstar of Korea's earlier performance. You see the number 10 and the number 11. That's Kyung Soo, number 11, and Chan Won, number 10, were excellent for the Koreans in their first game today on pitch one.
Rodriguez back to Melo. No changes as yet for either side. We'll see how the squads manage to play into this game, although Elton Piresh, plenty of goals for the number six so far in this game. Portugal have four. The referee doing a good job of getting out of the way by sitting on the barriers. Inventive stuff from the official. South Korea coming in with a shot. And saved by Raul Vieira. It's Jae-yong. Now Piresh. Cross to Rodriguez. And Melo. Piresh, Melo. Rodriguez. We can see back into the slow passing. They patiently wait for any gaps to appear. And when that happens, they will move it quickly. They need a really disciplined defensive setup to avoid a big scoreline against Portugal. And they scored 10 against Belgium in their last game. That was earlier on today. 11 yesterday against Zimbabwe. 7 against Namibia. 5 against Hungary. It will certainly be Portugal and Hungary who will go through from this group. Portugal will fancy themselves as favourites to get into the overall homeless World Cup competition. And unlucky there from number 10, Chan Won.
It's interesting to see how the Korean team that's been brought this year has got a slightly different ethos to the one they brought last year. The last year's team must have had a combined, well, a sort of average age of in the late 30s, whereas this year there's a lot more young men playing for the Korean side.
Well, they're aided by Big Issue Korea, an organisation that's well known across the globe, encouraging homeless people to regularly exercise and therefore lead a healthy lifestyle and increase awareness about homeless people and encourage Korean society to accept and integrate them. The halftime whistle goes. I think for all their play, Portugal 4-1 to the good, but South Korea probably quite happy that they haven't actually fallen further behind there.
Well, it's a very strong performance from the base, from the rock. I mean, they've been very good of the South Koreans defensively at closing what is a devastating Portuguese attack down. And like I say, they're not the most skillful of teams, but they've done well to defend their goalkeeper. Here's a great replay of that. Well, first off the jumping referee, then second off this beautiful effort by the Portuguese number six, Elton Johnny de Vega Gomes Perez.
Just to give him his full name.
Oh, when you've got Elton John in your name, you've got to get it out there, haven't you?
Well, it will be full changes for the outfield players for Portugal. Vitor Pereira, Paulo Freitas and Vitor Santo all on. Pereira is number 2, Freitas 3, Santo number 7. Korea sticking with 7, 8 and 10.
We didn't see a lot of substitutions for the Koreans in their game earlier today as well. They're sticking with a similar formation. We saw 8 and 10 and then usually 11 or 7 on the field for the Koreans at any one given time. They've not used too many of their subs in this comp.
Yeah, Kyung Soo, you said, was a danger to look out for.
Kyung Soo was the number 11 when he's on, but that's a bigger danger. The number 2 from Portugal, Pereira, slotting that around Lee in the Korean goal.
Well, no change and let up in the quality on offer from Portugal. It is still top class. Vitor Pereira makes it 5-1 early on in the second half. Now Freitas back to goalkeeper Raul Vieira. Freitas to Santo. Now Pereira.
Back to building again for the Portuguese, you'd say?
Well, yes. Vitor Santo Rodriguez. I think he just got fed up with the passing between the other two, and he thought, no, do you know what? Give me the ball. I'm going to have a blast here.
Well, of course, you can overplay that three-on-two overlap quite significantly, but they haven't overplayed that one, have they? Brilliant goal by the number three.
Paulo Freitas picking out the corner. No messing about there.
A little bit of messing about there, though. Tough challenge by the number seven from Korea.
Paulo Freitas just looks to have taken a knock to the calf on his left leg there.
He's moved the arena about 3-4 inches across as well. So it's a very strong challenge on Freitas. Hopefully he'll be okay, though. We have seen some strong injuries in this tournament.
We have, but South Korea have a penalty kick. And it comes back off the post. So unfortunate there.
One thing that's fascinating to see from Vieira there in the Portuguese goal was the way that he went down on that penalty shot. He did essentially the splits to make his legs as wide as possible. Now that was the Portuguese tactic in the last tournament in Amsterdam that was famous, as it ripped the knee of Romeo, the goalkeeper for Portugal, and he continued to use that tactic throughout the shootout in pure agony. It was one of the stories of the last tournament. So Portuguese goalkeeping tactics have continued from Amsterdam.
Triumph in the face of adversity. Incredible stuff. Freitas and Pereira battling away, and look at that from Paulo Freitas. They're bringing out the tricks and the flicks.
He's recovered from that injury remarkably well, of course, Freitas there.
Certainly has, better than his country's captain in the Euro 2016 final. Cristiano Ronaldo didn't emerge back onto the field after his injury. It is Vitor Pereira. And Pereira and Freitas like to combine down that left-hand side and just wait for Santo Rodriguez. Right on cue, taps it home. Portugal have one more, and it's 7-1 to the Portuguese. Well, Futebol de Rua is the national partner in Portugal. They're supporting people suffering extreme poverty and social inclusion in the country. As South Korea managing to get back, and it's 7-2 now. They've got the ball in the net, but that one won't count. Great finish by the South Korean, though. Number 8. Now here's Chan Won. They've got their tails up a little now after that goal. Here, though, is Pereira. Now number 5 is Pacheco.
It's a great substitution for them, bringing on Pacheco there. Beautiful work.
It looks to me to be a full squad of strong Portuguese players.
Exactly. So what I'm really, really curious to see is when a team like Portugal comes up against an incredible squad side like Northern Ireland. I want to see those two teams going at it hammer and tongs, because the tenacity of the Northern Irish side might be too much for the speed and flair of the Portuguese team. You might see some colours flying all over the place in that one.
Yeah, the two Irish sides, Northern Ireland and the Republic of Ireland, are extremely strong. They are feisty. Well, you can notice over there, slight disparity in the scoreboard, Tom.
Yeah, there is. The scoreboard on the field, if you see that in the back left-hand corner of our main image, that will say 8-1, but of course, Korea have scored 2 goals in this game. So that's 8-2 to Portugal in this match. Korea getting 2 good efforts, really.
Yeah, they have. I need to give them their dues for that. It has now been updated. So we're all on the same page. Santo Rodriguez, number 7, to number 5, Pacheco. two is Vitor Pereira. With approaching a minute left of play, Portugal look to complete a fifth straight victory, five victories out of five in the group stages. Impressive stuff from Francisco Seta and Bruno Seco, the dual coaching team of this Portuguese side. It's Chan Won off the outside of the post. And the number seven, Jay Yong, couldn't tap home the rebound. Kyung Hon Lee, the goalkeeper for South Korea, quickly getting play back on, and South Korea will have a corner, a roll in from the corner position. And this will most likely be the final move of the game. Well, that was almost really well worked. Now, number 10, Chan Won, almost got in, but it was really well defended. And it might just allow Portugal one last chance. It wide by number 7, Santo Rodriguez. And that is the full-time whistle. Remember, please, you can donate to the Homeless World Cup for a £5 donation. Text GOAL to 70660. And also get interacting on Twitter at Homeless World Cup. No O in the world. Hashtag HWC2016 on Facebook, facebook.com/homelessworldcup, and on YouTube, youtube.com/homelessworldcup. Here we'll see the Portuguese at their very best, Tom.
Yeah, it's been absolutely fantastic from them today. Been very tight in attack, very controlled, and the Koreans doing well to limit them just to the 8 goals.
Full time, Portugal 8, South Korea 2. So,